Namaskar. Good morning. My dear friends and family of Hinduism. Today it's my great honor to be here. I am World Hindu Congress to address the gathering here of distinguished people. And thanks for inviting me here for this excellent program, which is, I was told, how we can talk about various linguistic organizations in promoting Hinduism throughout the world, especially in the United States. As our distinguished chairman introduced me as, I'm Haranath, Policherla. I'm a president for Telangana American Telugu Association. So I speak Telugu. I'm not so fluent in Hindi, so I elected to speak in English, so everybody else can understand. You know, let me talk about since it is a linguistic organization and I am representing foremost Telangana American Telugu Association, and why we have this association, and what are we doing about it, and what are the real goals and our priorities. Telangana American Telugu Association, our main goal is, one is promoting culture, the other one is seva. In the culture, it comes the language. We all speak Telugu. So in Telugu, there are so many wonderful poets talked about very good things about the day-to-day way of life. Without the language, we cannot get the essence of Hinduism, essence of the living of our forefathers. You know, I'm not expert in Vedas, or I'm not expert in any of the dharmas, but at the same time I know, when you are born in India, when you grow up in India, especially I am from Tirupati, what do they call it's a Vatican of Hinduism. And I was blessed so that I could go into Sri Venkateshwar High School, Sri Venkateshwar Medical College. After that I came to United States. So I got my degree in MBBS back in Tirupati. So we imbibe Hinduism, we imbibe the culture, we imbibe the knowledge through Gurujis, through going to temples, through listening to grandfathers, through listening to grandmothers, through listening to some of the poems which were given to us through various poets. So I can enumerate several poems about the things which makes me as a person. These are all part of culture, these are all part of the Hinduism, these are all part of the language. Unless we understand the language, we cannot communicate, we cannot decipher what we are going to say and what we are going to do for the next generation. I will say, yes, a small poem which Uppu Kappurambu Okka Polikanandu Chuda Chuda Ruchula Jadaveru Purushulandu Punya Purushul Veraya Viswadhagirama Viravayama. There is a poet called Vemana. He said, camphor and salt, they look like, but their qualities are different. The same way, around the world, we see so many people and everyone is different. And we got to give them the respect. They are unique in their own respect. So, these are all some of the things which I learned, and there is one more poem I wanted to say in Telugu and I'll translate. There is a poet called Sumati. Sumati is a poet from about 14th century. He said, Tana kopame tana shatruvu, tana santame tanaku raksha, daya chuttambavu, tana santoshame swarnamu, tana durkame narakamandu, divilo Sumati. That means, your own anger is your own enemy. Your own calmness, your own harmness, your tana kopam tana shatru tana santame tanaku raksha. structure that is going to, your own calmness is going to protect you. Tana santosham et swargam, that means your own happiness is heaven. Your own sorrow is your hell. So that tells you how Hinduism is transmitted through the masses. Even for a six-year-old, you can get that. This is the kind of a thing which I learned, and this is the thing which I wanted to give it to my next generation. My kids are important to me, and that's why I joined these organizations. Initially American Telugu Association, after that North American Telugu Association. Now currently I am president and co-chair for North American Telugu Association, Telangana American Telugu Association. Having said all that, what do? We do promote language, we do promote culture, we do promote festivals, we do promote the festivals throughout the United States. Well, what is the structure? We have a 30 different structures throughout the country. We are 5 advisory board members and 8 executive bodies and 30 board members, 35 regional vice presidents and regional coordinators throughout the United States. We do social service as well, in addition to promoting the culture. Social service includes helping people who are coming from India, students, Vidyadan, as well as letting the people who are coming from different countries in the United States to know how they should deal with the law, and as well as their resources and how to promote themselves, including promoting our religion and as well as language and as well as culture. So I was told, and at least I had a discussion yesterday, if we have these language related associations, how about all the language associations throughout the country, at least in the United States, come together and meet once a year and exchange ideas, exchange our struggles, exchange our enthusiasm, exchange our achievements, and come together, unity in diversity and diversity in unity. Our main goal is promotion of our culture, our religion, and we'll work for that. Thank you very much for giving me the opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you, Arnaji. So, we'll invite the second speaker, who will be speaking about the Tamil community. So, Bharat has got 17, I think, official languages. And the languages of Bharat, they are not regional languages. They are all national languages. So, we need to be very sensitive about this when we are speaking, because the languages of Bharat, they have sacred texts also. So, while we think about one language, we speak maybe one language, but being very sensitive, because those are not just mere language people talk, but there are secret texts also. And because of that, people really relate to them, connect to them. So if we have that sensitivity, I think we all would be moving ahead and working together. So I'll introduce the second speaker, Shri Balaji Rajgopalan. So Balaji is the founder and CEO of Music and Mind, a global organization providing cognitive analytics and artificial intelligence solution. He is a successful entrepreneur with deep interest in the Hindu culture, and he actively supports many temples, religious, social, cultural, and non-profit organizations. He understands Tamil Dravidian politics and does proper articulation of it. A very good example of his activism came during the Sri Adal issue, where he took lead in the Tamil community in US. He is actively engaged through Marathi Tamil Sangam and other organizations. I invite Shubhakarji.
Thank you, Sanjay.
would like to thank the World Hindu Congress and HSS for bringing all of us together on this platform. Great work. I am very happy to address all my Hindu brothers and sisters here. Slightly contrary to what you might hear, though there are some very common issues that all the linguistic organizations can come together and address, Tamil Nadu overall is a little bit more. I think our challenges are a little bit more deeper. There is a history behind it. Close to about 80 years of so-called Dravidian politics, which has been very divisive and anti-Hindu and anti-Bharat overall. Even when it started about 80 years ago, about 1940 or so, one of the Dravidian leaders wrote to the Queen saying that this state, we are not interested in freedom, we would like to be under your rule. To that level, it has got deep-rooted anti-Bharat. To some extent, it has been fought over a period of time by others, but not really so much. The base is still stronger, completely divisive. At the first level, they divided Dalits and Brahmins. Then they subsequently divided each caste in their own way, got funding from Christian and Muslim organizations, took over temples and all their assets, which is actually huge, huge in Tamil Nadu. Close to, somebody was giving me statistics yesterday, somewhere close to about 32,000, huge crores and crores of assets have been taken as the base to kind of really support what they have been doing for the last 8 years. Still strong, and today definitely it has become a hub for many anti-Hindu activities. That's just my personal view, having gone through this for the last at least 40 years myself. So that has basically come here as well. When I came into US, I was really surprised. There was a Tamil organization in Bay Area. They do not celebrate Hindu festivals. They do not voice against anything that's pro-Hindu. When the California textbook issue came, where the Hindu Dharma was projected in the wrong way, people were looking for support. There was no support. And obviously, that is kind of percolating, and how it came, and people who came from there also, to a large extent, are carrying forward the same mentality. That's kind of what we saw. So we started this organization when people came and approached me in 2000, 2002 time frame, that they really want to start a pro-Hindu Tamil organization. I was there, I don't want to support it. And since then, I've been part of one of the board of directors for Bharati Tamil Sangam. And we today do celebrate all the Hindu festivals. We promote Hindu culture. We voice against any anti-Hindu kind of messages, whether it is within Tamil community or outside. And in fact, one of our key person actually got attacked physically, in front of his house in US, where people kind of came and did the, because he was writing pro-Hindu messages on the social media and stuff like that. Instead of just coming, they kind of did try to attack through the social media and all that. They even started getting into more physical working. When we really went and understood the roots, we also realized that some of these people now started working for the same politicians back home, and trying to actually become a funding channel. Okay, so we are pretty much fighting this, and obviously we can't do it alone. It is not just at the schools. Obviously, when our kids go to school, when the textbooks say certain things which are wrong perception, they get I would call it as a suppression of their expression on their culture. It's prevalent. We're trying to support, educate. And the SBNR syndrome, what we call as spiritual but not religious. Okay, we really want them to say confidently that they are religious in people. I'm sure when they go to colleges, I was talking to the student council here, I hear the conversion approach quite common. And even at colleges across, interestingly, I just thought this is kind of more prevalent in the Tamil community, but definitely it is more common to also have this Indian student organization oppose the Hindu religious festival. They just want to remove religion out of the Hindu festivals. That's kind of what I heard. But obviously, there are definitely other challenges too on how they are socially confident, socially being able to talk about what culture they belong, what this means. There's a lot more work to do. It just cannot be all done, though at the language level, we can fight it. And one of the most other thing that also I want to quote here is that the scripts, whether it is the old Tamil scripts like Tirukural, even Carnatic music, are being plagiarized. As if it's all coming from the Western world with Jesus Christ and stuff like that. I mean, to that extent, it has come on. It's a much broader issue in my view. We are trying our best at the community level. I think it's very important that other organizations also recognize, because it's a question of time. If it can happen to our community, it can also happen to others. So obviously, I think that the need is more than ever to one come together to fight this as a common set of issues, be it in the colleges, schools, and creating the Hindu marriage forums to be able to really promote our culture. And most importantly, it's all our duty to take this great Hindu Dharma to our youths and next generation so that they can sustain on their own without us being able to support it. I think the work is much more, can't be done overnight. I think the organizations, other linguistic organizations which really believe in this, you know, if there is a similar kind of spirit exists in other places, it might be challenging to bring all of them together, though the intent may be great. But I think whatever possible, whoever possible, the organizations that share a common view have to come together, have to collaborate to fight this as a common issue for our next generation in US. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Balaji. I'll invite the third speaker from Kannada community, Sri Anil Deshpandeji. Anilji has been a community volunteer since his student days while his master's from ISC Bangalore. He serves as Vice President Technology for Seva International. He was the President of Kannada Kuta in Chicago chapter in 2010. He has served on the board of directors of ACCA in 2010 and 2011. ACCA stands for Association of Kannada Kutas of America, a non-profit educational, linguistic and cultural organization to integrate, coordinate, network and unite the activities of all Kannadigas and Kannada Kutas for promotion and preservation of Kannada languages and culture in North America. I invite Anilji.
Namaste, and brothers and sisters of Bharat. And I really appreciate World Hindu Congress getting this all together. That was required, always required. So congratulations for that. So I represent a
a state called Karnataka in Bharat, and Karnataka is known for several things. The most important thing I recognize is Karnataka is the birthplace for Hanuman. Kishkindha is part of the Karnataka. So when Hanuman introduced, when Hanuman flew to Sri Lanka and he achieved the great things and went, and Ravana asked him, "Who are you?" He said, "Dasoham Kaushalyendrasya." He never said, "I am the great valor soldier or anything." He said, "I am the servant of Ramachandra." Similarly, Kannada has that culture in its mind, in its anthem, Karnataka anthem. It introduces itself as Bharata Jananiya Tanujati. That means we start our anthem saying Jaya Bharata Jananiya Tanujati. That means this daughter is from Mother Bharat. So we always say we are part of the Bharat as her daughter. And this daughter is the richest, one of the richest daughters of Bharat. The reason is Karnataka has contributed so many things. It is 2000-year-old language. It has the richest and highest Gnanapita awards, Sahitya Academy awards in Karnataka for the literature world. Purandar Dasa gave the Carnatic music to Mahatma, our Bharat. And Madhvacharya gave a different thought process on the spirituality. And Basavana gave Vachana Sahitya. And there is a Dasa Parampara, they gave Dasa Sahitya. There is a very rich. And Sri Krishna Devaraya ruled the biggest empire compared to any other emperors in Bharat, whoever has ruled for 235 years. And there are beautiful temples you have to go and visit in Karnataka, including Hampi, which is ruined by, which maintains the history of the atrocities by the foreign invaders. So everything there, that is how I call it as the richest daughter of Bharat is Karnataka. So now the language I am talking about, it has so many very good, again I did mention about the Sahitya Academy. Now also the language is very rich. You must have heard S.L. Bhairappa and others whose books are translated into several languages, including English and other things. And you must read some of his work because they are so valuable. And one of the another author I want to mention about is D.V. Gundappa. He has written, it is called Kannada Bhagavad Gita. He has written a Vanku Timmana Kanda, which is almost in quality, it is equivalent to Gitanjali by Rabindranath Tagore. It is work which is equivalent to getting a Nobel Prize kind of thing. That is such a rich culture in Karnataka, but they are so humble people. You must have seen in Bangalore, all the entire Bharat is existing, it is a cosmopolitan city. And it is well known for the IT industry and all those things. So everybody knows Karnataka because of the IT industry. Even Americans know Bangalore because of IT. So having said that, Karnataka is a very rich and very accommodative standard Indian standard Bharat mentality. We consider as Vasudev Kutumbakam. We are always the mentality of Vasudev Kutumbakam. So that is the best part of Karnataka. Now how we do in US, what we do as a Kannada community in US? Kannada community in US, we are involved in promoting and preserving Kannada language and cultures. If a language is lost, culture is lost. So we preserve our language, through that we maintain our culture. And we organize, coordinate, network, and do a lot of events, 5 events per in a year kind of thing. And we are totally aligned to the Sumantrate Sumitrante, World Hindu Congress concept. So that means we think collectively and achieve anything. So that is, we are already in the same mindset of World Hindu Congress. And in charity work, we have a charity wing in each Kannada Kuta which collects funds and gives it to the different charities in Karnataka. So we are part of all the things what the World Hindu Congress does, we are already having that. We represent, like, though World Hindu Congress is a cosmos, we are an atom. Right? We have the same pattern of all the things like charity, education, human empowerment, all those things. Go to the next slide. So Karnataka has Kannada Kutas in US has two organizations. One is ACKA, that is Association of Kannada Kuta of North America, and then there is another called NAVICA. So these are the two organizations, umbrella organizations across the US. They conduct the conferences like this every once in 2 years. That includes the same pattern like forums, youth forums, business forums, education, women and charity, and cultural and literary activities. It is the same as what World Regional Congress is doing. And it is so coincident. Last week there was a World Kannada Association meeting that was happened in Dallas. We are around 40 Kannada Kutas all over the US. Each Kannada Kuta does the same kind of activities, like conducting the festivals. We do not, there are some pseudo secular elements associated to, because it is mixed, it is familiar to Bharat, right? So it has pseudo secular mentality people, but it is predominantly, we celebrate all the festivals, that is Hindu festivals. That's how we continue our Hindu culture, and we pass it on to our next generation, involving them, involving the youth in our Kannada activities. We run the Kannada schools, we bring the Kannada movies, we do all the things that is necessary for an ecosystem to maintain Kannada activities. Through Kannada activities, we maintain the Kannada culture. Through Kannada culture, we maintain Hinduism. So we are part of the mission that World Hindu Congress is trying to do. And I'm really thankful to this organization, World Hindu Hindu Parishad, who are doing amazing work of bringing all of us together. Now, my request to all the linguistic organizations here is, when I was president of Kannada Kuta in Chicago, we did a winter Olympiad. That means we brought everybody together, conducting the carrom board, badminton, table tennis, cricket, everything in different places, so that every family meets. That's how they share their values, their culture. Because Kannada is not formed as one state. It got from Hyderabad, from Hyderabad, Karnataka, Mumbai from Mumbai, Karnataka, and Madras section, and Kerala section, then we became Karnataka, right? So like that, we are all related to you guys. So my request to you, we should have something like Olympia across our organizations. And we'll bring the culture together. That's how we can connect together, and Sumant Ritesh, Sri Krante, we can achieve. And we shall work together. That's my request. Thank you.
Thank you, Anil. So, if you have been listening carefully, so all the three speakers they spoke on all the languages. Just now you mentioned about DVG, Gunapaji. Same thing, if you go into Tamil, you'll find out Telugu then. Profound writing, profound. So when you read about Telugu, dharma artha kama, moksha is not there. But if you do kama, and with the desire is there, and with action is there, with dharma, moksha will be in there. Without saying so, it's already added over there. So phenomenal writings are there. Yeah, so all those, all the languages, they are sacred. So again, I will continue, and they will come with Telugu also. So these things are there. I'll invite the next speaker about Gujarati, and that is Dr. Vasudev Patelji. Dr. Vasudevji is a medical professional from Bharat. In 80, he joined his father's medical practice in Mehsana, Gujarat. He is a community volunteer and is associated with both profit and non-profit organizations. He took an initial action to motivate doctors and lawyers group in Atlanta to help the leading Indian community to free basic primary care and a legal aid. He is also an entrepreneur and involved in diversified businesses in the USA. He was a key player to arrange a live talk with Chief Minister of Gujarat and Gujarati NRI community more than 6 times in the last 12 years in the month of May and under Gujarat Indian celebration. Currently, Vasudev is working on how to bring all the various Gujarati community across America come together and work on the bigger issues. So Vasudev, please.
Thank you. Namaskar, Jai Sri Krishna. To say about Gujarat and Gujarati community, Gujarat has given Lord Krishna, Gujarat has given Mahatma Gandhi also, Gujarat has given Sardar Patel also, who has united the India, and Gujarat has given the Narendra Modi also. Definitely Marathi is there. I agree with you. That's what we are here to work, to unite everybody together. That was probably the motive for him to go to Banaras. As far as Gujarati community is concerned, you can find Gujarati community all over the world. Even traveling for business or other reason since last 300 or 400 years back. And since then, they were well established in all over the known places of the world where they can do the businesses. The same way, in any part of US, you see, you will find at least small hotel, or nowadays gas stations. You will find Patel or Gujaratis everywhere. And if you travel, I travel across from California to New York while I was in New York, and I got a couple of places, free Gujarati food, and free residents also, while they come to know that I am Gujarati. So we are everywhere. As far as associations is concerned, there are 57 Gujarati Culture Society or Gujarati Samaj kind of associations are existing and well established and well sufficient, very powerful association in the US. But we do not have any association which connect everybody together. Here we are talking about all the Indians get together. But if we don't have one stage, like some lucky stage has it, so that is the reason I start working on that one. And I convinced so far so 39 associations get together. Still I have other to contact. I know I can reach to all of you. I travel many states also. Specific this reason with my time and my money. But after all, when we are getting together, we always talk about India and how to connect the India. And not us, our next generation also. And that is a big long-term thought process. We have to give them freedom what they want to do it. We cannot tell them you do this way, then they will never associate with us. If you see that VAPS and some other temple association, they are doing so marvelous job in that direction. Directly or indirectly, they are preserving Hindu Dharma, that is it, and connecting the next generation. We are fortunate as the Atlanta Gujarati Samaj has our own 40,000 square feet building. We rent to every community, comes to us, any kind of celebration they want to do. And we are happy to help them out. That is one of the reasons we started the program, where everybody get together. Just few weeks back, right now Gowda is under the election for governor twice. And I went with the consulate general, we met the one of the leading candidate of the governor. And I was proudly talking with him that 130,000 Indians are living in Metro Atlanta. But after 10 minutes we stopped, his secretary told me, Mr. Patel,
Bangladeshis are voting more than you guys.
Even though you are 130,000. Maybe Bangladeshi must be in few thousand.
So we are sending this message also. We want to preserve ourselves, but we want to put our roots strongly in the country we live. Then we have to mingle with this society also. And that is the reason we started the Legal Aid Society. In our team, we are only 4 Indians and 9 Mexican, other Colombian communities. We want to reach across, even though we started. We are providing, with some dollars help, the free service. Same way, the medical service. Even the more Indians are taking the benefit of that. Every Friday we are running the clinic. Every Friday, free between 12 to 5 in my time. So this is not just for one community, it is for all the community, and to put the our roots powerful, and the other community living here should respect us. Then we will preserve ourselves for a long term goal. To keep our community together. Yeah, for seniors we run the computer classes, they don't got bored. They can communicate with back home, their people, exchange the photographs and whatever they have done, that helps them. For the youth, we are doing the youth camps. And we are teaching them why you have to be proud of being Indians. You have to know the achievement of Indians. Otherwise, when they go to the school, they always think that whatever has happened, this all magic is done by only these people. We have to tell them from zero to today, everything, most of the things is ancient, and for 5,000 years back, these all things were existing in a different manner. So that is how we can work together. We have to bring all the community together. And I believe in every city we have to do one activity or one event together as a being an Indian to show the power of India. And always the power works. Like example, New York City, if you see that India Day parade, I remember when I was there, I was participating in that association. In the governor office will start 1st of January when this you have the event. So this is a kind of power we have to create being an Indian here. Always Indians, we got 90% are us. If only we talk about Hindu, you cannot mingle with other communities. So always our agenda is supposed to be in the background. And we can work on that. Thank you.
Thank you, Asli. Thank you, Asli. Please keep your questions handy. In the end, will be Amiji will be moderating that question. So if there are something, so use the channel number 108 on Slido. So we'll be using that. I'll invite now Shri Avinash Padhyeji from Marathi. Thank you. Shri Avinash Padhyeji is the president of BMM, Lehan Maharashtra Mandal. It's an umbrella organization for more than 65 mandals across North America. He is proud that BMM initiative Policherla is thriving with 68 schools across North America with strong volunteer support. He has a strong passion for Marathi literature. He is an electrical engineer by profession and has roots in printing industry. He started his own print business in Bharat before migrating to USA. I invite Avinash ji.
I was kind of contemplating how should I address this wonderful crowd. I'm living for almost 25 years in the United States, and most of the time when the English language is used to address, it's very easy to say ladies and gentlemen. on the same ground, I thought, maybe I should go with Mahila or Sanjay. But I stopped right there. For a while, I thought, this is the 21st century, and I don't think that in this auditorium, there would be anyone who wouldn't have heard Krupaya apni kursi ki peti baandh lijiye tatha shaujalay ka prayog na kare. I stopped. And thank you so much for Sanjay ji, Abhi ji, for inviting me and felicitating my beloved organization, Brahman Maharashtra Mandal. I am very proud to stand right in front of you to let you all know about what we are doing. Maharashtrian community have been in the United States for more than 50 years. And there are many heroes from our society, but one of the unsung hero, or heroine I would say, was the woman, Mrs. Anandibai Joshi, who came to the United States, and she was the first woman to be admitted in the Western medicine faculty. She was here to get educated in medicine. Imagine the hardship she might have gone through almost 120 years back. But at that time, even though there were hardships, she had that courage to come to the United States, educate herself, practice, and when she went back, all her fears vanished because the entire Bharatiya community stood behind her. She went back to India, she went back to Bharat, and she had the most glamorous, glorious welcome. All the community, you all know that Mumbai is a cosmopolitan center, and all the communities offered the help because this was one of the most courageous steps a woman could take. And I'm proud that since she has laid the foundation, someone like me, I could come and address such a wonderful crowd. Brahman Maharashtra Mandal is a 38-year-old organization. It's an umbrella organization. We have, as Sanjay ji has already introduced, that we have more than 65 Maharashtra Mandals across to North America. Like all my fellow members, we are also trying to preserve and protect as well as propagate Marathi culture throughout North America. One of the things what we achieve is we organize a biannual convention. Next year we will have the 19th convention. It will be organized in Dallas, and almost 4,000 attendees from all over the world, they do attend. Our organization is a cultural organization. We do our, as most of the speakers have mentioned, that we all, our community is very secular. We are very open-minded. Even though we do not openly say that we are Hindu organization, but our roots are Hindu. And even though all our 65 Maharashtra Mandals are independent, we do not have any directive, but all of those, I'm very proud to say that all of those, the programs what they organize are around the Hindu festivals. And that's what is the spirit of the community, and I'm very proud of that, without being told someone is doing on their own. With the same idea, we thought that Marathi Shala would be far more helpful, because our next generation need to be also in this mainstream. We have now more than 68 Marathi Shala across North America, and they are growing. They are growing exponentially. The growth right now is almost 15% a year for last 3 years. I'm very proud. And one of the reasons for this growth is we have a structured program. We got like a lot of stalwarts from the educational field in the United States, as well as noted educationists from India, from Bharat Maharashtra, helped us. And we have tied up, we have a tie-up with Bharati Vidyapeeth, who have specially catered and designed a curriculum for our next generation. And we do have an exam system. That examination is being held or organized by Bharati Vidyapeeth. They are assessed by Bharati Vidyapeeth, and those who graduate do get certificate from Bharati Vidyapeeth. Some of the states, Georgia as well as Illinois, and these are the states where our leaders have worked hard to get those programs accredited into the mainstream, and those who could go to that extent would get the credits for the college entrance. I'm very proud, and I would be happy to work with all of you guys, because you have done extensive work in the field of this language. I'm so much thankful that all of us have gathered here with the passion, one passion, that as a Hindu we could unite. And I guess our language can definitely cross those barriers and meet these goals what we have in our mind. Thank you very much for being patiently listening to me. Thank you.
Thank you, Avinash. We have got still two more speakers. So I'll introduce Judhajit. Shri Judhajit, Senmazumdar. Judhajit ji is an IT and social entrepreneur based in Silicon Valley. He's the chief advisor to Kolkata based I Initiate, a skill development premier investment arm. Judhajit ji brings over 2 decades of experience in dharmic activism and has time and again championed the cause of Hindu human rights in West Bengal and Bangladesh. He is also North America's chief coordinator of Nava Banga, a movement with a mission towards new and vibrant West Bengal. He is a graduate of NIT Tiruchirappalli, and his schooling is from Kannada's RK Mission Vidyalaya. I invite Judhajit ji to share.
Namaskar, shabai bhalo to. I'm so blessed, and it feels so amazingly well being part of such a blessed, you know, symposium, such a blessed, you know, event called World Hindu Congress. It's a great privilege. It's a great feeling, and you know, being part of and being with, you know, in an environment where a lot of us, as brothers and sisters, we all believe in common goal. We share the same passion, and you know, as Sanjay ji says, we are hearing the different communities, they're talking about the challenges, the activities they're doing. When I'm going to talk about Bengal, it's a very interesting case. Bengal, which started from, which happened to be the epicenter of Hindu spirituality, from Yogananda ji to Prabhupada to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to our own Swami Vivekananda ji, Paramhansa Ramakrishna Maharaj. What happened to that? From, you know, from the Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay to Sharat Chandra Chattopadhyay to Rabindranath Tagore, you just name it. The epicenter of Hindu spirituality, the epicenter of Bharatiyatva. What happened to that land that today we have to talk about and bring about the organization that I am representing called Nava Banga, which believes in the renaissance of Bengal, bringing the passion, bringing the saffron, ideology and bringing the beauty of Bengal once again. So we have to understand what happened and why happened and how we are thinking to bring that lost glory of Bangla Ma and Bharat Ma. So talking about my speech, I will divide in few sections. First I will talk about a little bit of the interesting case that Bengal is, what happened to the state. Then I will move what we are doing in United States of America and Bengal from Navabongo and the festival of glow for Bengal. And the third part, I will come back to the challenges we might be feeling. So to start about Bengal, which happened to be that epicenter of Hindu causes, the problem that it faced has gone through a lot of lot of challenges, in the sense the state which created one of the biggest resistance against the British government had to go through the pain of partition, right? Bengal and Punjab are the two states had to go through. And then the same Bengal, which happened to the epicenter of dharmic ideal, activities, which used to love the physical activities and the dharma and the spirituality. After the partition 1947, when the plethora of the ocean of people from East Pakistan, the Bangladeshi refugee Hindus have moved to Bengal, that is the time when somehow communists able to change that. They had a lot of anger, they had a lot of struggle, they had a lot of pain, and they somehow vented out, they have converted that, instead of understanding what is the reason of their pain, why they had to go through, how come their religion made them refugee, they kind of convert that anger towards the beach. So in Bengal, whereas we should understand being socialist capitalism is the only way you can eradicate poverty, the same people start believing the rich is my enemy. And that feelings has kind of completely changed their ideology of how to bring Bangla Ma, how to bring Bharat Ma to their lost glory, to more hate people who are rich. They start bringing all the typical communist ideology, and we see one after one decade of our best brain lost to the nationalism, lost to the anti-nationalism, and the land which happened to be the proud land of Swami Vivekananda become the today's date. I am ashamed to say that a lot of people from the Tukra gang and anti-Narendra Modi ji are come from, some of the connection from that. And that's where we have stood up. We thought, we understood under the leadership of Shomen Purkasthi ji in Bharat, and with all the blessings of a lot of our Magdarshak, that time has come, we have to change this game. We have to bring back our lost glory. We have to bring the Bharatiyatta and Hindutva feelings among our Bangla people. Because let me tell you, the same Bengali people who you might see, they're talking about Tukre Tukre or talking Bharat Ki Tukre Honge or talking Modi ji. It's just two layer of anti-nationalism. And if you can able to wipe it out, it's all saffron. Let me tell you, it's all saffron. The same people who said Vande Mataram and Khudiram Bose, who put their life for to Ma Bharat, that DNA, that gene is right there. So it's not lost, brothers and sisters. We all have to come together. We have to join hands. And Bengal is the final destination. If we are able to make Bengal saffron, we are able to make Bengal into the fold of Bharatiyatta. The group which talks about the Break India Forces, they will understand that if Bengal can be changed, they can never touch Bharat. So that should be our ideology, that should be our goal. So talking about that, so we are the Navabongo, which talks about the renaissance of Bengal, and which talks about, it's a kind of a campaign which connected a housewife in a district of Bakura to an engineer of Silicon Valley. It talks about, it understand the importance of something called citizenship bill. Today's case when NRC is a huge issue in Bharat, we have to understand my brothers and sisters of Bangladesh Hindus who get persecuted day in day out, or the Hindus from Pakistan, they are our own brothers. If we don't raise the citizenship bill and make our own, who will do? Bharat is their ma, Bharat is a living mother for them, and we all have to take that responsibility. So as a Navabongo, like, we believe in the Bengal Renaissance, we believe how to you know, save Bangla Ma from jihadis. We also believe that, you know, people, you know, the bills like National Citizenship Bill and helping my brothers and sisters of Hindu Bangladeshis, we have to take care. And the same passion we have to bring it in USA also. We are the, I'm proud to say, we are, you know, the only Sangh-driven on Sangha ideology believing Bengali organization in entire North America, which believes in bringing more and more. Plus one karte jao, jute jao, jute jao. In Silicon Valley, where I'm from, with the blessing of one of the eminent cardiologists you probably heard, Dr. Ramesh Japraji, we call Festival of Globe. We call Festival of Globe, which bring everyone together. And I'm the chair of COP Bengal. You won't believe, 10 years back, we used to, you know, spread the leaflet of the Hindu persecution in Bengal to the different Durga Pujas on the car shield. And today, we organize the Durga Puja in the heart of Silicon Valley where 10,000 people join. And we always bring, we make sure that the organization like our HSS and other Hindu organization can have their booth, they can talk and bring the, spread the news to the Bengali masses. Be it Silicon Valley, be it NRIs, be it Pashchim Bongo, so that all can join hand and all can come with the single passion of bringing Bharat, the glory to Bharat Ma, bringing, you know, the safe, the land of Bangla, which is the eastern part, you know, eastern corridor of Bharat Varsha. And if we can't able to save Bangla from the venomous eyes of the jihadis, the entire Bharat is in risk. So it's not only our, you know, the people like me or the other Bengali, it's a common agenda of all the Hindu brothers and sisters that Bharat, which is our identity, which is our everything, we have to save Bharat, we have to save Bangla. We have to bring the name of Nabo Bongo, what Shomendra has started there and we are all carrying, you know, which today we are proud to say we are the only Bengali organization, Nabo Bongo, which got the appreciation from the Legislation Assembly of California. It's a big, big proud moment for us who believes in Hindutva among the Bengali community, who start and we start bringing, adding more and more friends, who even happen to be the communists, but through our own friendship, own charisma, own, you know, the friendliness, we are bringing them. They believe, just to say, if Judhajit is saying, if it's my friend, maybe that is true, let me listen. And once they listen, we talk logic, we talk brother. No other group has become refugee 2 times. If we become refugee, we will be the only group in the world who become refugee 2 times. We lost our land in the eastern part of Bharat, which become Pakistan, and we only have 1/3 of the land left. You know, we are talking about a lot of good things, we are talking about Rabindra Sangeet, poetry, and you know, the land from your feet is moving out. So this is the time you have to raise the consciousness of being Hindu. You have to help the people who are doing amazing work in, you know, Bharat, in the Bangla. Our Bajrangal BHP brothers are trying to bring the lost glory and we are keep helping them. Namaskar, Shabai Bhalo Thakben. As we said, Modi ji, for you like we have Pokra and Khapra, we have Rasogolla too. Dhanyawad.
Firing speech. I think you all will agree with that. Thank you, Judhajit. We'll move the last speaker. Last but not the least, Sukhi ji. We've been working together for almost 2 to 3 years almost. So I know that though he's in the last, but great contribution towards the Dharmic causes. So Sukhi Chahal is a founder and chairman of Punjab Foundation, which provides educational support for 500 plus underprivileged children with special needs in Punjab. He is actively involved in the Sikh community and plays a role in building bridges among the Hindu and Sikh community. He is president of Information Technology and Unified Communications Computing Company in Silicon Valley. He attended UC Berkeley for Computer and Stanford for Management and Research. He held senior management, engineering and consulting positions in Silicon Valley. For this presentation, we went together in San Jose Gurdwara, which is the largest Gurdwara in the US, and with the management team also we discuss what are the things we will be presenting here. So he is here and present Mr. Sukhi.
Or How about now? Is it okay? Thank you, Sanjay. Thank you, Namaskar. पहले तो जो स्लाइड है लगी है संजय जी मेरे को बहुत खुश कर रहे थे कि टेबल स्लाइड होना जरूरी है, लेकिन मैंने संजय जी को बोला था कि मैं दिमाग से ही बात करता, मैं दिल से बात करता हूँ, दिल से जो निकलती है असर रखती है, पर नहीं ताक दिल से जो निकलती है असर रखती है पर नहीं ताक ताकते प्रवाद मर सकती, इसलिए दिमाग से नहीं जो बात हम आज कर रहे हैं वो दिल से कर रहे हैं। इन्विटेशन मेरे को आया, थैंक यू वेरी मच, लाया गया कि जो हम सोशल काम कर रहे हैं वो तो काम कर रहे हैं, लेकिन सबसे पहले मेरे को जहाँ आने के लिए इतनी तकलीफ उठानी पड़ी शायद किसी को मालूम नहीं होगा, हर कोई यहाँ आना चाहता था, लेकिन जब लोगों को हमारी कम्युनिटी के कुछ लोगों को पता चला मैं यहाँ आ रहा हूँ, उसी दिन से मिस इन्फॉर्मेशन और डिस इन्फॉर्मेशन मेरे बारे में कि आप हिंदू ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के प्रोग्राम में एज ए सिख जा रहे हो बहुत बड़ी गदारी कर रहे हैं, और मैं उन लोगों को बताना चाहता हूँ अगर वो मेरे को मेरे ये एफर्ट को कि हिंदू और सिख भाइयों को साथ कर सकता हूँ कम्युनिटी आउटरीच के लिए, ऐसे में काम कर रहा हूँ, मेरे को वो गदार करते हैं तो आई एम प्राउड ऑफ बीइंग ए बिगेस्ट गदार इन इंडिया। यहाँ आकर मेरे को बहुत अच्छा लगा, मेरे को भी पर्सनली कैसे जब आपके पास बहुत कम इंफॉर्मेशन होती है उसी हिसाब से आप अपने इंफॉर्मेशन फ्लो करते हो प्रोपोगंडा करते हो, लेकिन कल आकर मेरे को सबसे अच्छी चीज़ पता चली जब मैं बिगेस्ट हाउ में बैठा हुआ था आरएसएस के चीफ वहीं थे, जब उन लोगों ने स्लाइड जो प्ले की के हीरोज ऑफ हिंदुस्तान हीरोज ऑफ भारत गुरु गोविंद सिंह का नाम आया था, और जब भी फादर डे आता है तो मेरी फेसबुक प्रोफाइल पे गुरु गोविंद सिंह की पिक्चर होती है क्योंकि वो मेरे पिता हैं, उनके पिता ने गुरु गोविंद सिंह के पिता ने शहादत दी थी, किसके लिए दी थी, हिंदुओं के लिए, कश्मीरी हिंदुओं के लिए दी थी, आज दिल्ली में जाओ चांदनी चौक में जाओ ऐसा नहीं है कोई कुछ लोगों को 99% सिख हैं उस वो कभी भी नहीं सोचते कि हिंदू और सिखों में ऊपर हम भाई भाई हैं साथ में रहते हैं कोई ऐसी इशू नहीं है, जैसे संजय जी ने बोला गुरुद्वारा में जाते हैं 30-40% जो सैनोदे का लार्जेस्ट गुरुद्वारा है नॉर्थ अमेरिका में वहाँ हिंदू भाई कोई नहीं पूछता आप हिंदू हो या सिख हो, लंगर खाओ कहीं भी जाओ कुछ भी करो कोई नहीं करता, लेकिन जो परसेप्शन होती है एक परसेप्शन है भी जो 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 सिख लोग हैं वो एंटी इंडियन हैं, नहीं ये गलत बात है, ये गलत फहमी है, ये गलत मैसेज जो प्रोपोगंडा किया है, कुछ लोगों की दुकानदारी इसी पे चलती है और दुकानदारी को चलाने के लिए वो ऐसी बातें करते हैं, जैसे हमने देखा था पहली मेरी स्लाइड में कि सिख लोग यहाँ पंजाबी लोग हैं 1900 में जहाँ आए थे जहाँ आकर जो जो तकलीफें उन लोगों ने उठाई, क्योंकि आजकल तो आना आपको जहाँ सेटल होना बहुत ईजी है, उस समय ब्रिटिश का राज था हिंदुस्तान में, जहाँ आकर जो उन लोगों से ये हमारी जो बात होती है उनके इंसेस्टर से बात होती है बहुत मुश्किल से यहाँ पर इन लोग ये लोग सेटल हुए, सेटल होने के बाद फिर भी ये कौम है बहुत मेहनती कौम सिख कौम, और दूसरी बात ये सभी का भला मानते हैं, आज भी केरला में हड़ आया अभी दूसरे लोग सोच ही रहे थे, लेकिन देखने वाली बात है कि सिखों की कुछ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ने वहाँ लंगर लगा दिए थे, जहाँ भी कोई इंसिडेंट होता है हम हमेशा पार्टिसिपेट करते हैं, लेकिन मिस इन्फॉर्मेशन डिस इन्फॉर्मेशन फिर भी पैदा होती है, संजय जी अगवा हैं इनके वाइफ सैनमुझे गुरुद्वारा एवरी ट्यूजडे जाते हैं शाम को, बहुत लोग जाते हैं, मैं भी मंदिर में जाता हूँ, पंडित जी बैठे हैं बैठे हैं मैं इनके मंदिर में जाता हूँ, हमें कोई ऐसा नहीं है, लेकिन कोई डिस इन्फॉर्मेशन होती है वो प्रोपोगंडा किया जाता है। बहुत इवन के पॉलिटिक्स में दिलीप सिंह था 1954 में वो आए थे वहाँ पहले कांग्रेसमैन बन पंजाबी कम्युनिटी से। उनके जो कंपेन मैनेजर थे अभी मैं 3 हफ्ते पहले भी उनके घर में मिलकर आया डॉक्टर अमरजीत मारो वो कहते थे कि इतनी ज़्यादा डिस्क्रिमिनेशन थी उनके पास उनके सिर पे पगड़ी थी लेकिन उन द बैक एंड वो कंपेन मैनेजर थे ही कुड नॉट गो आउटसाइड टू मीट द पीपल क्योंकि अगर उनको पता चल गया भी ये सिख है ये ऐसा है तो शायद उनको वोट नहीं मिले लेकिन बिहाइंड द सीन उन लोगों ने काम किया एंड दे मेक श्योर एटलीस्ट हमारी कोई रिप्रेजेंटेशन होनी चाहिए 1954 में पहले कांग्रेसमैन बना बड़े व्यक्ति उसके बाद मेरे की जहाँ भी जाते थे पहला काम करते थे गुरुद्वारा बनाते थे गुरुद्वारा बनाना चाहिए वहाँ से हमें जो नॉट ओनली स्पिरिचुअल एक स्ट्रेंथ मिलती है एक हमारे कल्चर का भी एक हिस्सा है बहुत बड़ा हिस्सा इसीलिए हम ऑलवेज इनवाइट के कोई भी किसी भी कम्युनिटी का हो सोसाइटी का हो हमें दे आर मोस्ट वेलकम। तो उसके बाद मेरा मैसेज मैं ज़्यादा स्लाइड पे जैसे मैं कहता भी दिल से बात करता हूँ ज़्यादा इस पर नहीं ध्यान देता आज तक जो भी काम किया है और आगे भी करेंगे हमारे बहुत लोग होते हैं अभी पैसा बना लेते हैं लेकिन ज़िंदगी में थोड़ा सा टाइम निकाल करना जो दूसरी कम्युनिटी के कोई लोग हैं ना उनसे भी बात कर करके देखो पता चलता है कि हमारे पास कोई मिस इन्फॉर्मेशन और इन्फॉर्मेशन का काफ़ी था। जैसे कल मोहन भगवत जी ने स्पीच में सबसे बड़ा उनका जो एजेंडा था हो सकता है कि हमारा हिंदुस्तानी है हमारे में डिफरेंसेस होना चाहिए लेकिन एंड ऑफ द डे हमारी जो सोच है ना वो कलेक्टिव से सोच होनी चाहिए उसी सोच को मैं भी मानता हूँ ये सोच है बहुत अच्छी सोच है जुड़ी नहीं है कोई थोड़ी मोटी डिफरेंसेस होते हैं उसको बुलाकर लॉन्ग टर्म बिगर पिक्चर को सोचना चाहिए लेकिन इसमें इतने देखो कि जो स्लाइड है इस लास्ट स्लाइड के नीचे कुछ मैंने लिखा हुआ है तो डार्क डेज ऑफ पंजाब पंजाब बीइंग ए स्टेट ऑन द बॉर्डर बहुत देर से पहले जब भी मुगलों का अटैक होता था तो पंजाब बीइंग ए बॉर्डर स्टेट वाज ऑलवेज देयर अहमद शाह अब्दाली आता था वो बर्बादी करके जाता था हमारे बहुत बहुत नुकसान होता था उस समय से जो सिखों का लड़ने का लड़ाई का या जो जोधा जसूर भी करता वो सिखों में है लेकिन उसके बाद एक काला दौर हुआ 1970-80 में उसको वो हम बोलते हैं डार्क डेज ऑफ पंजाब कुछ हमारी पॉलिटिकल सिचुएशन थी कुछ हिंदुस्तान और या पाकिस्तान के जो बीतने से जो इशू थे उसको जो विक्टिम बढ़ा वो सिख कौम बनी गुमराह किया गया कुछ लोगों को गुमराह किया गया उसके बाद हमारा बहुत नुकसान हुआ दरबार साहब पे अटैक हुआ दरबार साहब को डाल दिया 84 में सिखों पे अटैक हुआ बेसारों पे अटैक हुआ कितने हजार लोग मारे गए दलों में टायर मार पकड़ मार दिए गए अगर कुछ लोग आज कहते हैं कि वहाँ अगर अमेरिका कनाडा में जाते हैं कुछ लोग बोलते हैं हिंदुस्तान के खिलाफ बोलते हैं कुछ लोगों की बोलने की वजह है आप लोगों को समझनी पड़ेगी दरबार साहब पे अटैक हुआ वो हिंदुओं को कसूर नहीं था दरबार साहब पे अटैक हुआ वो क्यों हुआ उसके पीछे आज तक किसी ने कुछ कोशिश करने की उसको समझने की कोशिश नहीं की उसकी कोई अपॉलॉजी नहीं 84 का इश्यू हुआ कितने लोगों की मौत हुई आज तक एक भी किसी की कन्विक्शन नहीं जो दुख होता है ना जब इनजस्टिस होती है उसको आप तो इग्नोर कर सकते हो कोई भी इग्नोर कर सकता है जो फैक्ट होता है एक मैं बात आज बताना चाहता हूँ जो सिख कौम है ना आई एम सिख ये भूलते नहीं और ये छोड़ते ये कभी नहीं भूलेंगे इसके लिए इस चीज़ का क्लोजर बहुत जरूरी है मैं गवर्नमेंट को भी रिक्वेस्ट करूँगा जो 84 को जस्टिस मिलनी चाहिए क्योंकि इसी से साथ एक बात जुड़ी हुई है जो बहुत मेरे को बहुत पहले मैं आप मिस इन्फॉर्म था HS पुल का जी जो इसका जो केस लड़ रहे हैं 3 हफ्ते पहले 4 हफ्ते पहले शायद कैलिफोर्निया में आए वो कहते हैं कि यार साहब आप यू आर आल्सो मिस इन्फॉर्म कहते अगर हिंदू इब्राहिम सिखों का 84 में हिंदुस्तान में ज़्यादा नुकसान नहीं हुआ वो उसकी वजह थी आरएसएस। वो क्यों कहते कि आरएसएस के लोगों ने हिंदू को लोगों ने सिखों को बचाया अदरवाइज इसके ज़्यादा नुकसान था जो 10 times हो सकता था। वो कहते भी हमारा मैं उसको भी एच एस पुर का हरविंदर सिंह पुर का सुप्रीम कोर्ट के अटॉर्नी हैं इनके 84 के केस लड़ रहे हैं। कहते जी मैं भी किसी हिंदू के घर में लुकर ये देखो कि उस हिंदू के बारे में सोचो अगर किसी को पता चल जाता तो उसका क्या होता है। इसीलिए वी हैव टू ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द कम्युनिटी मैं भी हिंदू सिख और हिंदू कम्युनिटी के सभी लोगों को बहनों को भाई को बहुत धन्यवाद करता हूँ। अगर कोई बात कहीं भी होंगे किसी के दिल में भी हो उसके लिए मैं माफी चाहता हूँ।
So first of all, I just want to say that all the panelists have been extremely wonderful in sharing their diversity. The diversity from all the different languages that make us into a unified country. But at the same time, they've also highlighted the commonalities that we share individually and intrinsically within each one of us. And that is what we should take away from today, is that there is diversity in unity and unity in diversity as well. So with that, the first question is, this year at Tampa conducted a Hindu Sangathan Divas, but not able to bring any linguistic organizations. Please suggest how to bring them together.
I think this forum has really helped. I hope it's really a beginning. We are more than happy to come together for the larger causes. I think we definitely want to make it more and more inclusive. It's about our Hindu Dharma, and we also make it inclusive. And we are more than happy to come together. But I think the way to reach out is to probably a central forum, or I think most of us have been associated with the local HSS kind of organizations, and that will also be a good way for us to come together.
Thank you. The next question is, how can we motivate organizations that were set up for and are driven by their language or distinctive culture and sampradaya? Yeah. The question is, how can we motivate organizations that were set up for and are driven by their language or distinctive culture and sampradaya? So, Avinash, please.
Hello. I think this forum has created the groundwork. That's what I believe. And in my opinion, to connect with the community, our future generation is something far more important, and that's what we have to look for, because they have far more open mind and new ideas that can bring us together. One of the forums that we have here is Economic Forum. So I believe that if all of us, all these linguistic communities, we can work together and nurture the entrepreneurial qualities among all Hindus, that economic upliftment, and that will definitely have a far more broader outreach, because the mind will be far more clearer from the economic point. And those can be one of the driving factors. That's what I believe. And from BMM perspective, we are trying very hard to get the younger generation into that mode and connecting with the younger generation on the economic and entrepreneurial activities. Thank you.
Okay. we have questions on Slido, and we're going to follow these questions. You can definitely ask the panelists after. You can definitely ask the panelists after any questions you may have. You may approach them and ask them any questions you may have. At this time, I'm going to follow the questions that were provided to me by the audience using the Slido tool. The last question is, we've been talking about individual linguistic organizations, but what about bringing them together under one umbrella, either regionally or nationally? And I believe that was the intent of this particular session anyways, but I'm going to have Sanjay Ji address this and close this off.
Excuse me, sir.
So, almost like you all have been doing more technical issues. So, generally we think it's kind of issue. The issue is about at least one of America. So, please come in the evening, session number 6 at 4:30. Then we'll come to know more about that issue and how the community like this came together. That's the reason we have been fighting this issue since 2005. And in the last 3 years, the community has been coming together and we are getting strength. And because of that thing, what we were able to achieve on 9th of October last year. And the march, we are still marching because we have again got more success recently also. So please come in the evening and find out why we all need to come together. And world currently, if you all know, it only listens strength. And we all know about Bhagavad Gita. Shri Krishna was giving message to Arjuna and he is accepting. Yes, but. He only surrenders when Bhagavan shows him who is he. In chapter number 11, Vishnu Darshan. Oh wow, this is divine. This is ultimate. So power ultimately speaks. So Arjuna, after that, if you see, chapter number 12 onwards, his queries are very different. But before that, his queries are very different. So strength is there, then we can do all these things. And the whole theme of Gowda also is Sanghe Shakti Kali Yuga. So if together, if we are organized, we can achieve things, bigger things. But celebration of diversity with the help of languages is a very good thing, but we also need to connect together once in a year at least for every day. In the beginning, I think we all will meet together, we have better plans. How to come together from that? What is the conversation? It's not only platform that we are meeting, but we should be meeting locally, come together, and work on the issues accordingly. Thank you very much.
One thing I personally also have realized is as we talk more and more, some of the issues that we are fighting are common. Some of them are language specific. I think that language specific work, promoting the language should continue. But I think the more, even if we can come together in forums like Olympia and stuff like that you were suggesting, that will help us understand the common issues better. And that itself will make us come together, is my view. And again, this platform has been very helpful for us.
I want to add one thing in this one. They say bola gaya, dialogue is very important. Itni ke dialogue nahi hota na kai bar hota hai ki dusri community hai dusre log hai uske sath hamara milbatta nahi ho raha hai. Dialogue you have to start. Jaise Gurnan Dev ji ne hamesha unka yahi message kaha hai. Dialogue has to start. You have to start from somewhere. Itni der to dialogue nahi hota na itni der हमारे बीच में से जो प्रोपोगेंडा मशीन होती है ना वो हमेशा दे आर वर्किंग फुल टाइम दे आर वर्किंग हार्ड एंड दे आर डेडिकेटेड एंड दे आर वेल फंक्शनिंग वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड क्योंकि हमारे पास लिमिटेड रिसोर्स होते हैं हम काम करते हैं एवरीबॉडी बिजी करने जा रहे हैं अच्छे हैं लेकिन ऑन द अदर साइड एक्चुअली द फोर्सेज वी आर फाइटिंग एक्चुअली सो दे आर वेरी वेल फंक्शनिंग दे आर वेल फंक्शनिंग फ्रॉम आउटसाइड हिंदुस्तान आउटसाइड भारत एंड दे आर वेरी डिटरमिंड उन लोगों के से लड़ने के लिए उन लोगों के पीछे जो और लोग होते हैं जो पीछे बैठ कर इसना के जैसे मेरी मैं कहता हूँ कि इट्स नॉट द एक्टिविटी ऑफ द रेस्ट ऑफ बट द एक्टिविटी ऑफ द गुड पीपल विच इज हर्टिंग द सोसाइटी जो इन एक्टिविटी होती है ना 99% जो चुप कर बैठ रूप बन जाती है ना घरों में हमने क्या लेना है सबसे ज़्यादा कम्युनिटी का नुकसान बोल जुम्मेवार होते हैं
I have a question for all these people. They were very dynamic. We know that
every language in our India is very, very academically very rich. Unless our kids learn that language, the rich experience they will not have. Just like our Marathians, we know that unless Marathi is learned, Nyaneshwari and Tuparam's Gatha will not be understood. Right? But Ashok Singhalji and I, we were in Banaras for a few times. He had come to our temple before he died. And so he was telling us that all of these organizations produce more provincialism. So are we doing anything that we should not have any provincialism? Academically, each language is very good. We have to have our kids learning that. But do you, I don't see any address that they have done. Is it that they encourage the kids to go to RSS or HSS where all the Hindus are together? I am Sangha Chalak of one Shaka and I see that all of these kids come there. So do you have any plans for that? That I want to ask.
Okay. Very good question about how, if I understand the question properly, how can we promote Hinduism, how can we promote the overall togetherness and how when it's put together. As I said, as you said, Antiji, language is very important and at the same time all the languages are important. And we have all official languages, and with the organizations, we're just trying to talk to our kids, talk to our younger generation, try to attract them towards our culture. By that, we are getting their ear. Otherwise, we lose them. In America, the kids have their own mind. They go to schools, they are taught different things. Then we come to the temples, we teach them different things, they're confused. But only way we can keep the dialogue going is insist on our literature, insist on good things which were told in the literature, insist on the messages in the literature. Yeah, in Telugu literature, I just spoke about two poems, and those talk about the wealth of knowledge, the pearls of Hinduism, inside that our country. So we got to put it together, and we should also be talking with all the other organizations how we are doing, so that we will do good things for our Mother India, Mother Bharat. Thank you.